This next story is one of exceptional resilience and generosity in the wake of Hurricane Katrina.
Rebuilding hope and memories. That was the inspiration for a one-of-a-kind celebration.
And they say this is their way of paying it forward.
Hi, my name is Jeff Parness, and I'm founder of the New York Says Thank You Foundation. Over the past 5 years, I've had the privilege of starting 4 national nonprofit organizations.
The origin of it was kind of sad. One of my business partners was killed on September 11th, Chagai Sheffi. He was 35 with 2 kids. I thought about Chagai every day, thinking, what do you ever do to commemorate somebody who died in a tragedy like this? 2 years later, my 5-year-old son told me he wanted to send toys to kids in California who lost their home in the San Diego wildfires. That suggestion led to the creation of our first foundation, New York Says Thank You. Each year on the 9/11 anniversary, we take New York City firefighters, 9/11 family members, Ground Zero construction workers, and scores of other volunteers from New York, and we send them to different communities around the United States recovering from disaster to rebuild something. It's our way of saying thank you for all the love and support Americans extended to New York after 9/11.
The second organization we started is CJ's Bus Foundation. Along with Catherine Martin, a young mother who lost 3 family members, including her 2-year-old son CJ, in the deadly Evansville, Indiana tornado of November 2005, we started CJ's Bus.
It's a 40-foot custom school bus that you press a button and becomes a 20-foot wide building. It's outfitted as a complete mobile recreation unit so that all our volunteers could drive to disaster sites to set up emergency childcare facilities. This last spring, we cared for over 600 children in Midwest tornadoes and floods. Our goal is to have multiple CJ's buses around the country in the next 4 to 5 years. The third foundation I helped to start is called Build for Life. It was inspired by Benita Keeley, a 38-year-old mother battling terminal breast cancer in Bay St. Louis, Mississippi, who lost her home in Katrina. Inspired by Benita's will to live, we started Build for Life. The focus is to help rebuild the homes of other cancer patients and to empower cancer survivors to be the volunteers on those projects.
Last fall, we told you about a young boy, a kid from Mississippi, who had more than enough to worry about even without a catastrophic storm because he suffers from leukemia.
And lastly, we started Tony's Room Foundation. Tony Natto was a 6-year-old boy in Slidell, Louisiana, battling leukemia, whose home we had the privilege of rebuilding following Katrina. We built his fishing deck, then we built his house, then we built a clean room attached to his house so that he could recover after his bone marrow transplant. Tony passed away in June of last year. To honor his legacy, we created Tony's Room Foundation. The focus is to help build clean room environments in the homes of other children battling leukemia around the United States.
New York Says Thank You is a special way for New Yorkers to give back to America. It's also a special way for Americans to celebrate the sense of humanity that we experienced as a nation on 9/12.
Our volunteers have been a cross-section of America. We've had investment bankers swinging hammers alongside New York City firefighters, swinging hammers alongside Amish men. We've had children as young as 5 years old working on these projects and seniors into their 80s. The common theme in all of our organizations is we empower survivors. We empower survivors to transform their grief into unique ways to help others. And we empower survivors, whether they're survivors of 9/11, natural disasters, or cancer, to do something uplifting and life-changing by helping other people. I've seen how important these experiences are to our volunteers, and I'm absolutely convinced that someday we'll have 100,000 volunteers. I hope you'll choose to help me in these unique and life-changing experiences. Thank you.